Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutel. The topic that we are going to do today is atmospheric pressure. So what basically is the atmospheric pressure? We have now established that pressure is directly proportional to the force, right? So the number of the particles that are there which apply a force is in the air, in the atmosphere, is the atmospheric pressure. It's one of the fluid pressure. So fluid pressures are two, liquid pressure as well as atmospheric pressure. Now if we talk about the atmospheric pressure, it is the air pressure which is exerted by the weight of the air present in the atmosphere. Now on the screen you can see there is troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere, right? So atmospheric pressure is due to the weight of the air present in the atmosphere above us. So like atmosphere pressure, it acts in all the directions. Now, right now, if I'm sitting, it is acting from all the directions, right? So on the surface of the earth, the atmospheric pressure is maximum. Why? Because as we go up from troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere, we will see that the number of particles of the air in the atmosphere, it keeps on decreasing. Now, since the number of particles, they are decreasing, hence we can say that, you know, the force applied will be less. So at the troposphere, where we have the maximum number of air particles, the atmospheric pressure will be more. Right now, let me tell you one more thing. See, at the sea level on the surface of the earth, the atmospheric pressure, it is maximum. This is because the column of the air which is above us, so the number of the particles from exosphere, thermosphere, mesosphere, stratosphere, troposphere, all the particles are exerting their weight, right? So the column of the air above us is tallest at the sea level, so we experience a maximum atmospheric pressure. Now the instrument that is used to measure the atmospheric pressure is barometer, and the instrument which we used earlier for studying in the liquid pressure was manometer. Very nice. Now as we go up in the atmosphere from the surface of the earth, the atmospheric pressure goes on decreasing. This is because as we go up in the atmosphere, the weight of the air which is just above us, it goes on decreasing, right? So if you are in the mesosphere, only the two layers, mesosphere itself and the thermosphere and exosphere, they are exerting weight. So all together, troposphere, it has a maximum air pressure, right? Maximum atmosphere pressure. Now on the troposphere as well, if I consider about the plains as well as at the top of the mountain, where do you think the atmospheric pressure will be more? It will be more at the plains, right? Because as we go up, we are going up away from the level of the plains, and thus the air column that is just above us is continuously decreasing, right? So at the mountain, the atmospheric pressure will be less as compared to at the plains, and that is why, you know, when you're flying or when you are there on the mountains, you might feel a pop-up there in your ear. That is because the pressure, the atmospheric pressure outside your body is less as compared to that which is inside. Now why do you think we do not get compressed by all of this atmospheric pressure that is, you know, exerting its pressure from all direction? It is because the atmospheric pressure which is inside us balances the atmospheric pressure which is coming from around us. Okay, so that is the reason why we do not get compressed because of all this air column that is just above us. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's see what is the atmospheric pressure here. So this is a beautiful simulation by Fate Colorado. I used it in liquid pressure as well. Let's quickly have a look at what is the value of the atmospheric pressure, like what is the value of the atmospheric pressure in air right now on the surface of the earth. Now this is a beautiful simulation by Fate Colorado. Here you can see that there is water inside. So I've used this activity in liquid pressure as well. Now I'll use this device. Now this device, if I'm using to measure the atmospheric pressure, is my barometer. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll place one barometer here. So let's say at this point, my atmospheric pressure is 101.312 kilopascal, right? Now, this the measuring is done in the millimeters of the mercury. So atmospheric pressure on the surface of the earth is 760 millimeter of mercury. So like atmosphere, if I take a beaker and I put mercury inside it and I put an inverted beaker inside it, the atmospheric pressure that is acting on the liquid will push the mercury inside the upside turned beaker, right? So the reading that is there on the upside down beaker shows me what atmospheric pressure is around us. Fine. So the level to which the mercury rises is 760 mm. Now in terms of Pascal, that is my atmospheric pressure, it is 101.31, okay, kilopascal. Now just have a look. I said that it is maximum at the sea level, and as we go up, the atmospheric pressure keeps on decreasing. Just check this out. So as I'm going down, have a look, the atmospheric pressure, it's increasing, right? So at the sea level, it is maximum. Now as I go up, have a look, my atmospheric pressure is continuously decreasing. So this shows that as I go up, the atmospheric pressure decreases. Simple fact about this is because, you know, the number of the particles that are exerting the force, it decreases as we go up, right? So that's a basic reason that is there to it. Now let's get back to our PPT. Now we have already done this simulation. So next is the application of this atmospheric pressure. So in your grade, it's not applicable. The calculation part of this is not there. Let's see where this atmospheric pressure is applied. Now see, when you are drinking a water through a straw, right? So the liquid, it comes up through the straw. How do you think that this liquid, it comes up? What happens is when you are pulling the water, you create a low pressure inside your mouth, and the water, it's at high pressure. So the atmospheric pressure, it pushes. Now this is at high pressure. I'll just write H here. And inside my mouth, it is at low pressure. So all the particles, all the liquid particles will go from the high to the low atmospheric pressure, and that is why we are able to pull up the liquid inside the glass through a straw. Next, you must have used this sucker, like we use this sucker to hang things, and it is used in games also, right? So what happens is, to make the sucker stuck on a wall, we first push it, and then when you leave it, it's stuck on the surface. This happens because when you're pushing it, you're removing all the particles that are present between the sucker and the wall, right? So as soon as you push it, all the particles are removed. Now, as soon as they are removed, it creates an area of low pressure, right? Because I told you, if the number of particle reduces, then the force reduces, so the atmospheric pressure will be low inside this. Now since it's low and the atmospheric pressure outside is high, so high pressure, it applies, you know, force from all direction, and thus the sucker is stuck on the wall and you can hang anything. So see, air is forced out and the atmospheric pressure, that is a high atmosphere pressure which is outside, it exerts a force, and inside I'll have a low atmospheric pressure, right? This is another application of atmospheric pressure. Now the third one is, how do you think the vacuum cleaner works? So a vacuum cleaner is basically, you know, inside the vacuum cleaner there is low pressure. Fine, there is an area where the vacuum is there. See, here it's partial vacuum here, right? So outside, since the atmospheric pressure is high because the number of particles are high, that's why all the air is pushed inside. Now since all the air is pushed inside, so the vacuum cleaner, you know, it works. So that is how it works. Now what do you think is vacuum? Vacuum is when the number of the particles inside a thing or a box, wherever you want to create a vacuum, are removed. So as soon as all the particles are removed, there is a vacuum. And that, since there is no particle there, so there is no force that is being applied by any particle, so we will have an area of low atmospheric pressure. Now next, how do you think, you know, a syringe, when you pull the piston, the water is pulled up? That is because as soon as you pull the piston of the syringe, the number of particles, they are the same, right? And the area increases. Now, if the area increases and since pressure and area are inversely proportional to each other, we have already done that, right? So since pressure decreases as the area increases, so we will have a low atmospheric pressure inside this piston. Now, outside the atmospheric pressure is more, inside the atmospheric pressure is less. So the liquid that is there, it gets sucked in. So as soon as the piston is pulled, the liquid is pulled up because of the difference in the atmospheric pressure. All right. Next, this thing. So this is a siphon. What happens is that, you know, as soon as you pull the water from here, like once you pull it up and as soon as you do it, though this area has low pressure and this has high pressure. So this siphon, basically, it pulls the water from this higher atmospheric pressure area to the area where there is low atmospheric pressure, because the number of the particles are less here and more there. Okay? So these are the four applications of atmospheric pressure. Let's quickly summarize what we have just done. So atmospheric pressure is basically the pressure exerted by the atmospheric air. This is measured by torusilli. See, as I said, there is this mercury, right? And in a beaker. Now, as atmospheric pressure is applied in the liquid, the mercury rises. This level is same as 760 mm. And hence, we say that the level of the mercury that rises is up to 760 mm. Fine. The atmospheric pressure is 101.3 kilopascal. Pascal is the unit of pressure. You must remember that. Next, I have the application. So it is used in a sucker, siphon, syringe and straw. I hope this topic is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do write in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to reply to those answers. Next topic, we will be continuing with more chapters of grade 8. Please stay tuned. Please do subscribe to our channel. Do like the video. And there are lots of maths and science related videos from grade 1 to 10, which will be available on our channel. Please do check out the playlist. Till the time, stay safe, stay healthy. Take care. Bye.